Welcome to Lost Roots Network with your boy DJ Gumbo. We're in the building with Shay the Geeker.
Gang, gang, what up?
The one and only.
That's right.
The flyest.
Okay.
The finest.
Okay.
Talk to him.
You know?
How you doing?
The big boss.
The big boss.
Big boss. I ain't got to even brag too much. My brag for me, bitch.
Okay. Can you tell the people where you from? What is your roots?
So, I'm from Cleveland, Ohio. Shout out to the land, you know what I'm saying? I am a black woman mixed with Dominican, but I'm black. I refer myself as black. But I'm from the land, you know what I'm saying? I've been in Florida for about 7 years. So, you know, I've just been cooking. I've been doing what I need to do. And I'm just here to inspire and motivate everybody else to continue to do what the fuck you need to do. You dig? So, we gonna get it popping. We gonna get this shit cracking.
Zoom out real quick for this one.
Okay.
What trials and tribulations did you have to go through to be who you are today?
That's a good question. I would just say it's been a lot of shit that has happened throughout my life that has brought me to this space today. You know what I'm saying? To be honest, like, I don't think I was supposed to see past 25, to be honest, because I was living my life on the edge because of the things that I decided to affect me.
Right.
So, you know what I'm saying? So I would just say, like, when it comes to trials and any tribulations, I think it's just a part of growth and building yourself up to get to a point where you want to be in your life. I tell people all the time, we create our own destiny. Nobody can determine where you go in your life but you. And that's based on the choices you decide to make. I decided to quit living that street life. I stopped living it. I was living it for a very long time. And then I just stopped. But all of that shit came from hurt, you know, growing up with the family that I grew up with. My family is not bad in no shape, form, or fashion. But I'm saying, like, you know, we get our toxic behavior from family. So, you know, people telling me that I can't when I know I can also plays a part in that too. I'm talking about teachers and shit at school.
Right.
I had teachers putting me down. I don't have to be here. I'm not here to babysit you. You're going to just be a low life anyway. Okay. You won't make it to C14. Okay. So just a lot of no's when I know where there's plenty of yeses. So, you know, once I got outside of my own box, I started following my own choices and destiny. And I did not doing what somebody around me wanted me to do. You feel me?
Being an independent woman, how do you deal with people that don't get your vision or they don't see the vision that you have for your career?
I really don't judge those people. Reason being is because it's not up for them to determine anything for me.
Right.
You know, so the main thing about doing something that you love to do is to do it because you believe in yourself. You gotta be your biggest fan.
Right.
You gotta be your biggest supporter, because if you don't support yourself, then how would you expect anybody else to support you? You must believe in yourself. You must continue to thrive by your own accord and not have nobody dictate nor determine that. You know, it's plenty of people that I be around even to this day sometimes, you know what I'm saying, when I choose to be around people, because I'm really a loner. But when I choose to be around people, there's plenty of people that I know possibly counting me out when they should have counted me in. But it's okay. I don't get mad about that. I don't become bitter and I don't become upset over it. I do become motivated by it though.
Okay.
Completely motivated.
So you use it for good.
Yes. Instead of
motivation.
Exactly.
That's it. 48 hours, nigga, not 72, nigga. What the fuck you gambling with your fucking life? You sitting up waiting. that nigga.
Yeah,
just
you know
let
what?
Him know we got
fuck
a bag
nigga.
To get.
No Potomita. We got a bag to get. Bring the bag.
We're gonna get into this question right here. Mm-hmm. What sacrifice did you had to make to maintain the lifestyle that you're living right now?
I made multiple sacrifices, a lot, but the main one was like getting away from my family, moving to a whole different area, and leaving them behind to actually want to live this type of lifestyle. So that was a major sacrifice for me. Maybe not for everybody, but for me, that was totally a major sacrifice. In life, you're gonna make sacrifices so that way you can get ahead, you know what I'm saying? But to me, that was a big deal, because to go from an area where you got your backbones there to go somewhere you don't know nobody completely,
right?
That's a very big step to take in life. So I do feel like that was one of the biggest sacrifices I have made. Totally.
Damn, I ain't gonna lie, you look good. To the music real quick.
Let's do it.
So when did you drop your first project, and how was that feeling like?
My first project, I dropped that motherfucker in 2011 on Reverb Nation. It's still on there to this day.
Okay.
But it was an exciting feeling, you know, because at that time, I really knew that I had great music. You know what I'm saying? Like, even to this day, I still would listen to my old music and be like, damn, that shit really still sound good.
Okay.
So it was an exciting feeling. It was a bunch of built up excitement, you know, like I never thought that I would have the courage to actually pursue it, because back where I'm from, they look down upon people who pursue music careers.
Why is that?
I think it's because of ignorance.
Okay.
In that state of mind of poverty. But totally ignorance, though.
They have no history of music over there in your city.
Oh, what? Bone Thugs and Harmony, MGK.
So after all that, it still don't believe that you can make it.
It's like, I think it's because of the people. It depends on the people you surround yourself.
Oh, okay, okay.
And I'm from the hood. I'm from the gutter. Like, okay. I am from the most bad area in Cleveland. You know, it's one of the worst areas to live in Cleveland. So, with that being said, yes, it's a lot of ignorance. It's a lot of people who totally look down because they don't feel like you would ever make it out of that area. And then once you do, that's when envy comes.
Mm.
But sometimes it doesn't even be envy. Sometimes people really just do support you in
right.
your growth, you know. But you do have some people who are envious and wish that they had the courage, because a lot of people who stay in those situations, in the worst situations they could possibly live in, that's because they're choosing to be there. They feel like they will never be able to make it out.
Right.
So they don't believe in themselves enough. Excuse me, it's the Bel Air. So once you get around a person who believes in themselves,
right,
then you know what I'm saying. You know, you look at that like, damn, I wish I had that type of, you know, attitude about life. Instead, you become convoluted with envy. And you don't even recognize it sometimes. Sometimes some people don't recognize when they become jealous or envious towards you. But to each his own, you don't judge them and you let them stay in their own league. You know what I'm saying? You do
right.
you.
Do you think educational knowledge is more important than street knowledge?
I think these things go hand in hand, but it depends on where you're getting your education from. You don't have to go to college to motherfucking become a super intellect.
Right.
You can learn that shit on your own. I mean, we got so many different platforms and tools now that we can utilize to get information or gain information and knowledge. So it's just based on how far you want to go. You don't have to go. Most people go to college to be a part of the elite, but even still, they don't become a part of the elite.
Right.
Okay, college will be a tool for that. Now, I do totally recommend that you at least finish high school in your life. And then if you want to further your information and education to become a super intellect like myself, then you could totally utilize the tools that you have in front of you. If you're on your phone every day, you could read a text message. There's nothing wrong with ordering a book, going to Barnes & Noble, reading a book about some shit. Not saying to take all information from a book as the truth, but you can always vet that shit. So to me, I feel like street knowledge, depending on where you come from, it's important to know that too. You don't want to be in a motherfucking alley in Pennsylvania, and you ain't never been over there, but you in Pennsylvania, you in Philly, and you in the alley right now trying to buy some weed from the weed man, because you from the suburbs of motherfucking wherever you from. You come up there, your ass get robbed. You ain't gonna know what to do. A person like me, I would know. First of all, I'm not meeting you. Nah, dude. I'm looking at this on Google Map. It look like an alley, my nigga. I'm sorry. Can you meet me at the gas station? Oh, okay. Well, then I'm out. You know what I'm saying? But also, it's just having the gift of discernment. You just have to be able to discern.
The Holy Spirit.
Yes, you have to be able to discern. Mm-hmm. What feels right and what doesn't. A lot of times we go against that voice in our head. That voice in our head is our oneness. That's us. That's you talking to yourself. Okay? It's not anything else. It's your divine energy. So you have to listen to that. That's right. How you're going to be where you want to be at, is once you start listening to your divine self, which is that little voice, which people call it an intuition and stuff, but it's your divine self.
Amen. Holy Spirit.
Absolutely.
What is your secret to balling?
My secret to balling is being smart with my money. I don't have to show my money. I don't have to put the money phone up. I don't have to fucking sit up here and pull $50,000 out of a book bag and a knapsack, Louis knapsack. I don't have to do that. So I just feel like the importance is to have lucrative investments. That's my secret. It's to ball in silence. You don't have to ball out loud. You can if you want to, but what you gonna do when that shit start fickling up? You know, then you done built a lifestyle that you couldn't even keep up with. It was moving too fast. So I choose to just ball in silence, and I choose to do my 1-2 in silence. I don't have to announce every accomplishment. I know what's being done in my life.
Man.
Rick, hey, and Thaddeus.
I got a bag to get. I'ma go get the bag. I got a bag to get. So I'ma go get the bag. I got all the cash. I got all the sweat. I got a bag to get. So I'ma go get the bag.
Your new EP, Gangsta Music.
Gangsta Music was just scratching the surface for y'all. Just to let y'all know, I'm still here. I ain't stopped doing music. So Gangsta Music was just a warm up to what I'm about to do next. So that's what Gangsta Music was. It was just something to let niggas know I'm still making music. I'm still doing me. Don't get it fucking twisted. Like, I'm still Shady Geeking, my nigga. So even though a bitch been sitting back and being quiet, I just been making moves. Like I said, balling in silence, doing my 1-2 in silence. But I'm here and I'm not going nowhere, nigga. So with that being said, Gangsta Music was just to let niggas know, yes, I'm still my G shit, which is that gangsta, and I'm still making fire ass music. I ain't gonna stop. Can't stop me. Nothing can stop me. Death can't even stop me. So nothing can stop me. Period.
You produce your own music?
I have producers. You know, most of the times, you know, producers send me beats every month, like beat packs for free. But, you know, common courtesy as an artist is to pay them producers for the beats you choose to use and push. So, you know, I do have producers. Sometimes I even still may use a fucking YouTube beat. I don't give a fuck about that, because I know how to email a producer and let them know, hey, I want to push this single and I use your beat. Woo-woo-woo. How much I got to send you real quick to lease it? Ain't nothing wrong with leasing the beat. You and the producer can get paid. Fuck right out of here with that craziness. So, ain't nothing wrong with that. You ain't got to buy a beat flat out or outright. You can lease that bitch. $50, $30 to the most they going to charge you to lease a beat. So, you know, just depending on how many beats of that producer you use, that's what's going to accumulate the money. So, just always do your business. Handle your business on the back end all the time.
Hey, okay. The business adventures that you own.
Okay, so I have a trucking company, Sure Transport, and I'm totally looking for drivers still. But also, I'm working on my clothing line, just an online boutique that has a lot of urbanated clothes. This outfit actually It's from my boutique, so I really like it. It's really comfortable. Plug real quick. But, and then I have a publishing company, Geeker Music LLC. Okay. And I also have a streaming company, a marketing media streaming firm, where we help artists get more numbers for their music. I don't really do it too much for mine, but I didn't find the right project to do it for. So this current project that I'm about to drop, mm-hmm. probably like tonight, hey. That's the one I'm talking about. So, okay. yes, you want to make sure you put a lot of money in investments behind your music. But that's really just it right now, besides like investing in stock, knowing how the stocks work now. That's about it. Bitcoin, cryptocurrency, by the way, too. Make sure y'all focus big on that, okay? Companies out there, though, that you can invest with in the States. So I suggest you look into that also. That's it.
Okay, so how it feels to wake up every day being a boss of your own company? How that feeling?
Hey, that's a motherfucking amazing feeling. Because it just shows that all your hard work pays off, you know, in the long run, as long as you continue to put your best foot forward.
Uh-huh.
Don't get it twisted. You're going to have some L's in this game. You're going to have some losses. Financially, mentally, whatever the fucking case may be, you're going to have some losses. Some days it's going to be bad. Some days it's going to be rough. But you got to know how to, you know, thug that shit out and get through it. So that's my biggest thing. Like, such an arrogant way of thinking about it. I'm going to put it like that. I'm very humble with waking up being stable. That's what I consider being stable. I think building generational wealth before you even have children is very important. Just in case you want to have children. I want to have children one day, but you know, my crush, I don't know if you know I crush on him. But that's another story. So it's like...
Well, what kind of man would it take to take you out on a date? What kind of man is qualified to take Shay the Geeker out on a date?
That's a good ass question. Damn, I never even thought of that. But I would just say, like, I don't do no dinner dates, so I just, you know, like, I already don't do dates, so
okay.
I be thinking in my mind, like, I'm so focused on getting this bread right now, I just don't need no distraction.
Hmm.
And sometimes you motherfuckers is distractions. That's why I like, okay, if I do go on a date, it has to be somebody who can talk about a whole bunch of shit that's very open-minded. Like, I'm a very deep motherfucker. Like, I get to the nitty-gritty. I'm gonna inform you on the stuff that I know.
Right.
And you should inform me on the things you know. So we share ideas back and forth. That would be an idea type of person. You dig? And you gotta be able to deal with the fact that I'm rough around the motherfucking edges. Cause I'm not a hood. I'm not a hood rat. You ain't gotta worry about that.
Mm.
But, you know.
Yeah. So what advice do you have for a woman that's in a bad relationship right now, but she's thugging it out?
Okay, so my advice, personally speaking, would be to leave that nigga the fuck alone.
If he's
toxic or shit, and I'm gonna be honest, it don't always be the niggas. It be toxic females too. Like, we got toxic traits. For some reason, women, we so prideful, we can't even admit that shit. It's so crazy. Like, I be admitting that shit with nothing. Like, cause I don't care. Like, I'm gonna admit when I'm fucked up. And I do have a bad attitude once I push to that point. Other than that, I'm the sweetest girl you could ever date, for real. But don't push me to the point where I have to come out of pocket. And I wouldn't push you to that point, neither. You know? But if you're in a situation that's not good for your mental health, man or female, I really suggest just let each other go, because it's just gonna keep draining. My first real relationship, it was like that.
Mm-hmm.
And that shit was draining. And that nigga still called me to this day, because I honestly put all that shit under the bridge. That shit, who gives a fuck? So, I'm doing great in my life. Life is good. So, I don't know, but when you think about those type of situations, you usually go through that when you're pretty young. You know what I'm saying? You'll get out of it, though.
Okay. Well, if you could see the... walking down the street, what would you tell her?
I tell her she need to calm her ass down. She was a blazer. She was crazy. I just always felt like somebody was gonna like harm me to the point they killed me and shit. I had bad energy around myself, really dark energy, because I was like mentally going through a lot, you know what I'm saying? So there's a lot of decisions that I still live with to this day that I have made that I can never take back, you know? So I think, you know, that's why I said I would tell her to calm her ass down, because I was trying to fit in with robbers and murderers. I was trying to fit in with those guys. And you know, you sometimes be led into a dark path if you allow that, you know what I'm saying? So it's okay when you a teenager. I don't think it's okay when you're a grown-ass person to be impulsive like that. You should be able to think before you react to some shit. Think before you go do some shit. If a nigga come to your house right now and be like, look, bro, I got the lick, woo, woo. You'll see, I know a nigga down the street with like 30, damn, in Cleveland, that sound like a lot of money to these niggas because they ain't never had shit. So they feel like they just want to take shit. You can have a mentality like that, but apply it to something that's fundamental. Not no dumbass shit like robbing another nigga.
Right.
So, but that's not how niggas thought at that time. You know what I'm saying? So a nigga come in the house and be on some shit like that, and then you go and you get yourself involved, and then your name comes up and your life is just over with because you took somebody else's life. You know what I'm saying? Like, right. Even if you don't get caught, it's not a good feeling to be involved in bad shit. It's not. And you young niggas out there, because my little cousin just got murdered last week. It's okay though. We're fine. We're doing good. The whole family. But you little niggas don't even know how to use guns. You're not supposed to use the guns on each other. You niggas are supposed to use the guns in a case of war. Somebody trying to harm you. War, nigga. You supposed to be out here just capping each other off like that. Like, you niggas is depopulating us more than anybody. If you gonna let your son or your daughter get a gun, you need to at least show them the responsible way of carrying that bitch instead of fucking having these niggas run rampant like this. It's crazy. But, I don't want to veer off track. You know that Bel Air kicking in? But we here, though. That's pretty much it, though. I would say about that, though. But it's just, it's crazy what we allow and what we are so susceptible and numb to. We allowed ourselves to become numb to these things. It shouldn't be okay. That's where I'm leading at. You can lay another one on me, man. Hello.
All right, so sipping on Miller. Girl from Germany. All right. How's it feel to be a African American woman in 2020?
I feel outstanding, nigga. I feel real good. Because of the growth and just because of what I've learned and come to learn, you know what I'm saying? So it just feel good. Like, I think everybody should feel good about themselves. No matter what your gender is, you should just feel good and live good and eat good too. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about healthy eating, but yeah. For real.
How important is it to invest into your dream?
I would say it's extremely important to put money behind something that you have a vision for yourself for. Like, if you got a vision to like literally go out there and build a fucking house, you're gonna go to the Home Depot and the Lowe's to build that fucking house. You're gonna buy the stuff if you really, really believe in your vision. That's an investment in your dream. But if you have a vision that you wanna build a house and you're just sitting on your couch, you're sitting in your house, you're sitting on your bed, you're laying in bed, thinking about building this house, and next thing you know, 30 years roll by, you still think about building a house. It's like, no, nigga. you should have been out there putting the idea into play. That's how things come into manifestation. Excuse me, you know, I be like, my brain think faster than how the words come out. So sometimes I be like just scrambling all together. But y'all know what the fuck I'm saying. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, that's really like what it boils down to. Like, to me, is like, is extremely important. That's the number one thing you should do when you have an idea. Mm-hmm. If you really trust and believe in that idea, not if it's a spur of the moment type thing, take some time, marinate on that shit, gather yourself. But if it's something you really believe in and you always wanted to do, do that shit. But it takes money.
Money talks.
It takes money, yeah.
Okay. Sure. Could you imagine a world without currency?
Mm-hmm.
Or if like currency didn't really matter?
Yeah, I can imagine that. It's wishful thinking at this point.
What do you mean by that?
I just don't feel like right now, that's one of those things that I can imagine, but I don't see happening while I'm probably here. It's probably gonna take another 100 years if niggas don't get it right this time. Niggas seem to not be getting it all the way right this time, but we're gonna see how it play out.
Well, what is more important to you in life?
Knowledge, information, because everything is downloaded in our memory bank. And it goes and it travels through lifetime. Mm-hmm. We're not the physical person that we see in the mirror. We're not those people. But we are the person driving the vehicle. So it's important to utilize that while you're driving it. Would you gonna buy a new Lambo Urus? Anything, you just gonna run that bitch off the road? Why would you do that? You crashing out.
Okay.
Good shit too. Good question, man. These motherfucking questions coming good. They sparking that dopamine in our mind. You know what I'm saying?
Dopamine. I do want to ask you this though. Can you tell the people the what's your definition of the word dopamine? Like, can you tell people more about that? I know it's a very important word that people should know about.
Yeah, dopamine. It's just a chemical liquid that's released in our brain.
Mm-hmm.
That determines the emotion at that particular time, or what would be considered the reaction a person is having to something. It's either exciting, it's either saddening, it's either something that cracks a motherfucker up to the point they just piss on their self. You know what I'm saying? Those are dopamines that's causing those things to happen. It's like released at a specific moment. And
I got a bag to get, so I'ma go get the bag. I got a bag to get, I'ma go get the bag. I got a bag to get, so I'ma go get the bag.
Give me a different look.
Fine look.
Thank you.
Smile.
DJ Gumbo, that's what's up. Yes, I'm so happy. We've been doing this interview for a whole like 2 hours.
For real?
I think it's about to be 2 hours. It's about to be 7.
I ain't supposed to be at the studio.
No.
No, I'm saying like.
We should be. On these lame hoes, lame hoes be talking, but they ain't got no game. Lame hoes be talking, but they ain't got no aim. You know what I'm on, bitches. You know what I'm on. I'm gone. Cleveland is in this bitch. Geeker gang, yeah, we rich. Geeker gang, yeah, we rich. Well, I know you ain't. We ain't here with DJ Gumbo. That nigga is a real nigga, man. For real. We going up all life. Fuck a year. We going up all life. Period.
Like, fuck.
Ain't nowhere to go but up. Like, can't nobody take that. We've been getting bags. We getting bags, more bags, big tags, popping big tags. Might bring some cash home in a paper bag. Who knows? You never know. We get into the bag. So if you ain't doing that, then you should change the way you live. Like, change the way you eat or something. Beat your feet. Get dirt. I don't know.